Hey, this is Nate Story with Bright Agritech, and today we're down here at Bayberry Fresh with Hayden Christensen, the owner.
We're going to be talking about mint today.
Mint is a great crop for ZipGrow towers, and you can see that Hayden has a lot of mint going here. It's a great grower, but it's also a great crop for market. So why don't you tell us a little bit about your markets and about the mint you're growing here?
Yeah, so it works really good for both home use consumers at the grocery store and restaurant markets. It works really good for live towers and cut products. So all around, it just really kind of hits every point.
So mint is a great crop because it's a really vigorous grower, but it's also really easy to propagate, which means you can scale up your system really quickly. You can increase the amount of mint in your system very rapidly in response to demand. And oftentimes, once people start selling mint, they find that the demand grows really quickly because most people haven't had really good fresh mint. It definitely has a shelf life. So, Hayden, tell me a little bit about your markets. Are they growing? Are they expanding? And what are you seeing there?
Yeah, so I actually didn't start out with a whole lot of mint, and I've always been adding more, and I'm going to be adding 3 to 4 times as much this year. There's a lot of demand from restaurants. It's actually the second highest volume herb for me, right behind basil. Also, I found out that bars will use a lot of mint alone and not other herbs, so that for that reason I can get a lot of customers just for mint.
You bet, and bars care a lot about really fresh stuff because, you know, the oils and the alcohols, the aromatic compounds in the mint are really what, you know, go into this drink. They dissolve in the alcohol, it's what people are tasting, it's what people are smelling, and so it seems that bars are almost kind of the ultimate market for really fresh mint.
They are, because they're looking for a garnish a lot of times, so they're looking for a really nice little sprig, and they're willing to pay more for it because they get a lot of sprigs out of a bag. So they really can provide a higher margin since they're looking for a really premium product.
Yeah, you bet. There's a big difference between just having a product that you grind up or you add to a dish, right, and having a product that your customers are staring in the eye,
right,
when it comes on their drink.
Correct.
So mint is a great crop because it's really easy to propagate. You can propagate it from cuttings, which means that once you've got a mature tower that you can start taking cuttings off of, you know, getting more plants is a pretty fast process. It's also super, super tough. So, you know, in our greenhouse, we usually just chop it right back to the face of the tower, all the way back to the crown. And once the plant kind of has some momentum behind it, it will just keep regrowing. So not everyone does that. I know that you do it a little bit differently, Hayden, but it's a great crop. It's very easy to harvest. Tell us a little bit about how you harvest and propagate here.
Yeah, so as far as harvesting goes, I want to get really consistent, high quality sprigs of a certain length. So when a tower gets to a certain size, is what I'll do is I'll find those sprigs. I can get a handful of them, and then I can cut them off. And then that leaves me, either I can cut the tower off clean after that to regrow, or it leaves a little bit of a plant left for a lot of new sprigs to come out of for the next cycle.
Starting mint from seed can be a really long process. Mm-hmm. Just as a warning, mint seed, germination rates are always awesome, and they're kind of a little bit picky, and they're slow growers from seed. So you definitely want to be taking cuttings. So when you take cuttings, you basically just drop them in your gutters, right?
Yeah, that's one way of doing it.
So yeah, Hayden just takes his cuttings and he just drops a handful of them down in his gutter, and they'll just root out there, and he just take them out of his gutter and stick them in towers as he needs them. But there are a lot of different ways to do it. We've done it from root cuttings before as well. Mm-hmm. So when towers get overgrown, which they will with mint, they begin to spread the housing, they begin to destroy the media. So it's best to kind of take them out and tear out some of that root material. And you can actually put that material right into a brand new tower. Just plant it directly to a tower and it will send out shoots. So it will actually, you can get plants pre-grown or grown right out of your tower just by putting the root material in a brand new tower. So mint is a great crop, and if you're just starting your farm or you're an upstart farmer, you should definitely be thinking about mint as well as basil. They're going to be both really marketable and really high margin crops to start with, and they both grow great in ZipGrow towers. Thanks so much for having us down here today, Hayden, and check out the blog at zipgrow.com if you have more questions.